So hello, in our IDS Vision channel session, how to find anomalies with machine vision. Yeah, sometimes it is necessary to detect process errors that can either be described or predicted. And as a consequence, there are no images with which we might train a classifier. The only thing that you surely know is the good state of your product or an object. And these challenges can still be reliably solved with anomaly detection. In our teaser video, you get an idea of the advantages of this function and for which application you can use it. In this video here, I will demonstrate how this method will be used from scratch based on a suitable use case. But don't worry, it really only takes a few minutes. Then we have a complete image processing running on our IDS NXT camera. You might know such connectors that are often used to connect printed boards in a small electronic device. And they also provide a secure electrical connections in a compact design. However, this is a mechanical connection and that have to be plugged and unplugged. This can also cause problems when handled not properly. And then might be the reason for a function error. Then such connectors can also look like this. Yeah, and even a single broken pin can lead to an electronic failure. And yeah, often such circuit boards are contacted and electrically pre-tested before assembly later in the device production. And sometimes these failures may occur when doing this. And unfortunately, these pin errors are hardly visible to the naked eye, yeah, on such really small boards. So the question we ask today is, yeah, can this connector be optically inspected by machine vision, yeah, after an electrical test, and thus automate the whole process? So let's see.
We start by taking pictures of the boards with the good connectors for training the AI. To do this, I place the boards in a stable cradle to ensure a consistent position under the camera. Then I start the IDS NXT cockpit and connect with my camera. Next, I set up the image to capture only the connector. This will ensure a better size ratio of the connector to the pin fault later in the image for the AI training algorithms. Then I open the crawler function to help me capture the images. I save them in the file system in two folders for good and defective boards. Then one after the other, I take at least 50 pictures of good boards and also a few of my faulty boards with pin errors and save them in the prepared folders. Now I switch into the cloud to our AI Vision Studio IDS NXT Lighthouse. There I log on with my IDS account and start working with my datasets that I've stored there. I create a new dataset to import my captured images of the functional boards for teaching the good state and call it connector train set. For the import, I change to the image data tab and add a complete image folder here. In the file system of my PC, I select the OK folder with the good images. And the folder name should be set directly as label for each of the images. With these settings, I start the upload and wait until all images are saved and labeled in Lighthouse. The train set is now complete. For tests and evaluation of my CNN, I create another data set that holds my recorded error images. I called it test set and upload my folder with the anomaly images here. Also, in this case, the folder name should be set as label for the images. In order to test the network not only with broken boards, I also add 9 images of working boards to this data set and give them the label OK with the upload. So now I have a test set with good and bad parts. Both of my data sets are now complete. With the existing data sets, we can now create and test our image processing. For this purpose, I switch to the neural network training and create a new anomaly project. First, I assign a meaningful name and then I directly select my image data with which I want to train my network. Here I select both my training set with only good images and also my test set. I configure how the selected data will be handled. I use the train set completely and exclusively for training, but the fully automatic process always needs some suitable images to test and evaluate the training results afterwards. So before I launch the training process, I have to set the maximum inference time that my network should take later in operation. The longer we give the AI time here, the more accurate the results will be. So the training is running and that also will take a few minutes. While our connector check is just learning what good parts look like, I'm already taking care of how the image processing will later on work in the camera and use the connector check. For this purpose, I create a new vision app project. I could also use the new anomaly use case assistant for this. This would create all relevant components, including the required vision app. The wizard would even import sample data for this purpose. This means that you can run this case for testing even without your own data in order to get to know the anomaly detection. But since I already have data prepared, I decide to create the app with the block-based editor. This way, I can also show you how easy and fast this can be done. I show the building process here in fast forward and only go into the essential points. Regarding the topic building vision apps with the block-based editor, there is already a tutorial video in our channel and also information on our website. Probably the most important process in the workflow is the anomaly detection function. I create a variable for the results and then I can use this analysis function. Another important parameter for our app is a control for setting the anomaly threshold. This will allow us to better adjust the separation between good and faulty connectors later on. All further steps rather serve to make the results visible in the user application or to communicate results via hardware interfaces. What is still missing in the final app design is the trained CNN that I have to insert here. Let's see what our training is doing. Obviously, the training is already complete. The test log shows me that my new trained CNN was able to differ the good and the bad connectors in my test data set quite clearly. The confusion matrix confirms this. We see that all the classes I set were also correctly predicted by the CNN. A good result. I choose the suggested anomaly threshold that should best detect all anomalies based on this test data set and the current training. In the inference result tab, I can even now run through my image processing with my test images. The heat map displays the detected anomalies and shows me where the CNN identifies larger deviations. If I wouldn't like the training result here yet, I could refine my training even before I build my vision app or put the whole thing on my camera and test in the real environment. But for my case, this fits quite well. So let's finish and test the vision app in the block-based editor. Now I can use the fully trained and also already evaluated CNN in my app. A look at the Objects tab shows me that our connector check CNN is now available. That means I can choose the CNN now in the dropdown of the analysis function. Again, I can test my app in the debugger to see if the process works. For this purpose, I use my images from the test set as camera images. So I can see the values of my variables in the right panel and also check the image analysis working for each image, as well as the result handling. And if everything fits now, I generate a version of my app and download it from the cloud to my PC. I now go back to the IDS NXT cockpit and connect to my camera. There we open the Vision App Manager and upload the new anomaly detection app into the camera memory. Once this is complete, I confirm the installation and wait for the app to appear in the manager. Then I can activate it. In the app configuration interface, I can see how it is working. To do this, I now place various circuit boards with good or faulty connectors under the camera. With the threshold slider that we have provided in the Vision app, I can still fine-tune the detection in the real environment. And that's it. My trained image processing also seems to work well in real-world environment. The workflow is now complete.
So let's summarize all this in a few words. An anomaly detection with IDS NXT can be solved fast. The workflow for this is complete and easy to understand, from the first image to the execution on IDS NXT camera. You're guided step by step through the entire process, and you have the possibility to return to any part of the process even later in order to detail and optimize your solution. An initial feasibility study can be made entirely in the cloud without any hardware. So you can easily check whether your use case will be possible to solve with AI vision. But also the execution of the final image processing on a camera is quickly up and running with just a few clicks. Oh, yeah, thanks, George. And all steps are easy to understand without special knowledge in image processing, machine learning, or application programming, and can be performed by anyone. So try it yourself. In our Vision channel, you will find many more videos about image processing with AI. Yeah, thank you for listening. Have a nice day and bye.